When I go to Raleigh, when I go to the state senate, I've usually got 5 or 6 things going on at any one time. And then you've got other projects that you're working on, actual legislation that you're trying to get passed. And then you've got bills that are coming from other people that you need to read and vet. At the end of the day, if you get 200 emails or 300 emails or 400 emails in a day, which is not uncommon, to be able to answer all of them, to stay until you're done, and know that you did everything you could for those folks. That's why I'm there. We need to be thinking more about how we can support young families. But before this pandemic, young families needed more help. But in the middle of it, you just can't imagine how hard life has become for a lot of these families with young kids. But now we're all focused on what they need. We're actually talking about it, we're thinking about it, because the problems are so much wider in scope. They apply to so many more families now. I'm working on criminal justice issues because we need to modernize our laws there, and the conversation has really changed there in a helpful way, in a bipartisan way. Working on affordable housing, which has been a really neglected area of policy for way too long, but also really impacts young families and working families. All of our kids should be able to go to preschool. A high-quality preschool. Families should be able to afford that without putting it on a credit card. Kids should be able to be somewhere safe. Families should be able to feel confident that their kids are going to have the best educational opportunity that they can be afforded. Those issues are about the future of the state, the future of our citizens, the future of our economy, the future of our democracy. I honestly believe this is going to be the best election of our lifetimes. I think you're going to see something really special happen. And next year, when these newly elected folks get to work, I think you're going to see from them an agenda and a responsiveness that we haven't seen in my lifetime. That's one of the things that I'm hopeful about, that the seriousness of the situation we're in is going to motivate people to finally come together around a set of broad principles that we can see would really help people, would help young families, would help working families.